The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, everyone. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technician's Hour. This is the noon to 1 p.m. time slot here at TFNN. Been here for since late 2002, early 2003, been a little while. And we're looking at a very unusual session, up 1,624 in the Dow at 20,211. Made a low just yesterday, 2,000 points lower at 18,213. We've been looking to go long for my subscribers to my opening call. We've actually been long a number of times over the past week. And we've taken either real quick gains and then got out with tiny little losses. But this is the period where I thought, and I said to subscribers today, we are going long, and I named certain positions. And yes, I said it's preferable that if there could be a little bit of a pullback, but we want to go long. So in this particular instance, it's the first time that I'm looking at a market that says, if there is still to be a couple of blows, in other words, let's say there's a, I don't even know what's going on with the debate right now, not the debate, but the debate amongst the politicians, there's room for maybe one or even two really big disappointments this week. But as far as I can tell, I had said yesterday that I think that the 18,200 level is really important to hold. We went to 18,213 in the Dow. Why did I say that? It's twofold, because it's a psychological reason. If you trade below 20,000 for a little too long, wow, that moment that we almost hit 30,000 when Barron's put out their front cover to say 30,000, like 30,000, yeah, we come. I don't remember what it was, but it said 30,000. Sure, they were expecting it, and we went to 29,500s, and then we turned around a little bit from the 29,568 area down to yesterday's low of 18,213. So an 11,000, almost 11,000, actually over 11,000 point decline in weeks. Look at this. Here's the weekly chart. 1, 2, 3. One little up week. 4, 5. This is the 6 week. In 6 weeks, going from an all-time high down to levels that haven't been seen for a couple of years. In this case, below the 2018 low, fairly near the 2016-ish area in the Dow. And you can go back to various indices, and they're all very, very sharply lower from all-time highs. But you remember I spoke about this the other day. I said, hey, wait a minute. In the volatility index, if you are looking at some kind of an indicator that says, are we overbought? Is there some sense of being overbought? Well, look at this. This is the two times long. I'm only using this because this is absolutely the sentiment favorite. Why? Because when it comes down even greater than you think. And because there is such a feeling of complacency, and really the VIX index is not, I don't like a fear and greed. I don't like that greed aspect, but it is a fear indicator. And the fear indicator went to 1,000. It was at 38 just 5 weeks ago. 38.33. And it runs, if you had ever said to me, what would be the high of the TVIX, I would have said, yeah, maybe we've been to, you know, hundreds before, maybe an exaggerated move to 220, 250. 1,000, I should put the date here, because I think this is going to be something we look back on and say, oh my, who paid the top tick for this? 1,000 on the 18th of February. Now, I don't want to use this because it's a shrinking. It's always shrinking. Look, once upon a time, it was 500,000. So this is not the, what you're going to be using. You have to use the volatility index itself to say, where are we, where were we? But at 1,000, and now you're trading at 322? And this is the uppercase, this is the Eiffel Tower, the ChapmanWave methodology. We've got a technique called the Eiffel Tower. Looks like an uppercase A. Goes straight up and straight down. If it comes back more than about 66%, 70%, that's a failure pattern. That is just terrible. Then you have to restart a whole new buy mode if it's going to do that at all. 170 is the 200-period exponential moving average. So we'll see where it ends on Friday this week. Single leg A could be a single leg A of failure. Hey, look, the dollar is a single leg A. Look at this dollar in the 94.65 3 weeks ago. It hits 102.99 last week. It's trading at 101.94. I was asked if someone wanted to add to their position. They've been very long time. We've actually subscribers have been long since April of 2018 at 90.07, the UUP. And I would say that probably you have to give it another day or two, because if it starts to break under 101.2, it could go lower, and then you could get the same thing in the weekly chart that we just saw in the volatility index. I don't think so. I think that the American economy is still the strongest economy in the world. At least at this point, I don't see the reason why to say it isn't. Believe me, when everything shut down, we're in a whole new dimension here. But I think that the dollar still represents currency of choice. And if you look at that, I think that between 101.70 and 101.30, it's kind of where I would look to say maybe that's where you want to add. I try to give it a little bit more time. I was thinking today that I might say take a little bit off. We've only taken a tiny little bit off since we got along. I just feel that the dollar is still acting extremely well. I mean, look at the euro, EUR/USD. Look at the euro currency pair. Had a big spike up, right? It hit the 9-period exponential moving average, the pink line, at 1.08. The high today was 1.088. And that's exactly the 9-period moving average. And now it's pulled back some. I think that the dollar is still there. The one, that's the one. All right, now let's go through the numbers. So we spoke about that, the QQQ. QQQ having a very big move up above the 9-period moving average, up 11.36 at 181.82, up 6.64%. The Dow's up 8.7, the S&P's up 7.7. So let me just do this. So I had a question about, where are you? Are you able to talk about it for your subscribers? Yeah, we've added some positions. One I'm going to have a question about, because I did say I'd prefer it lower down. It was really quite a bit lower down. Some people got in quite nicely before the open, not at the point that I said is preferable, but I want to be buying this. So I'm going to have to check to see how many people really got in, because I'm going to take the highest price. I'm not going to take the lowest price for this. And the other thing is, the Dow, we've been trading the diamonds. Took a profit yesterday in the diamonds. We did not get in. This whole thing was too quick. I missed an entry this morning there. I didn't say preferably. I said I want it at this price or under this price. But we did buy at just about the low yesterday. We bought call options, April call options, 192 call options. Obviously, 192 and the diamonds are trading at 201. Nice game. I'll be back in a moment.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN is launching an open house for our Tiger's Den. For a limited time, you can get a 30-day free trial to the Tiger's Den. Just enter promo code OPEN at checkout and pay nothing for 30 days while you try out your Tiger's Den membership as part of our open house. With market volatility at an all-time high and people all over the world working from home if possible, TFNN is hosting an open house in our Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is an interactive chat room that runs all day where other Tigers and Tigresses discuss trading ideas with the hosts and members, along with charts and current market news, as well as live access to the charts the hosts use during their programs. Join us for the Tiger's Den Open House. Begin your den membership today by just entering OPEN at checkout and pay nothing while you try things out for 30 days. For all the details and to start your den membership today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the TFNN Tiger's Den Open House taking place now. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Dow's up 1,632. Actually, it's only up about 400-500 points from the gap up open this morning. So far, it's really individual stocks that are starting to find strength, and certain sectors. I see the financial sector is finally doing a lot better, and another sector that we've been looking at as something we want to be in. That's kind of good. So the other thing is that with the S&P up 173, let me just do this. The IWM, the one I'm missing here, IWM, a very nice move up 7.58% at 107.47, up at 757. Made a low. It did not make a low yesterday. Most of the other charts did, sectors, that is. This was a low of 95.69 about 4 days ago. Now it's trading at 107, up 12 points. That's really good. So I don't know whether the small caps are going to do very well. In the meantime, this is a really good rally takeoff. I love the cluster formation, but you've got to break above it and say goodbye to that cluster formation. Now, there are going to be some things that come out in all the bills that are being signed and the amount of money that's going to go out. It's going to be unbelievable. And as I say, my expression is that the fine print later becomes the large print. And in other words, all the little boondoggles, all the stuff that they sneak in, eventually becomes way, way, way more important than now, because it gets snuck in. And it's a very important bill, because at least a line item that gets put in because somebody wanted it, and to get something passed, they have to do this. But it turns out for that particular person or state, it becomes really important, very big. All right, so IWM nicely, at least to hold 102 if there's any pullback in the next couple of days. The other thing is, I don't think all of this is going to be easy. We've got the whole thing with mortgages. In the Dan Peake says mortgage REITs, we're having trouble with margin calls. We won't know until, I wouldn't put it past maybe 3 months, even 6 months, before we find out what went through that should never have gone through, what should have gone through that was really important that just got bypassed. And what was really important in the sense that these are workers that most of the time we kind of forget about, but they were so integral and so important to everything that's going on right now that somehow they were overlooked. And I, you know, let's hope that doesn't quite happen. All right, let's go. Within the context of the TLT, you've had a 4.5 point pullback. It's at 161. It's stuck in this middle range. But my suspicion is that the yields are going to go a little higher, TNX.X. The yields, 8.85 on the 10-year yield, the TNX, it's at 8.85, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's kind of stuck here between a low of the 760s, but that the high could actually start to climb slowly towards the 10s. And that's just in the short-term period. And I think that's why it's helping the XLF. Look at the XLF. It's up 11.13% at 19.63. It was at up 11%. Yesterday, remember, we were talking about it. Oh, it recycled. So that was G/D. So this turns out to be a low. This is a D. And the low yesterday, what was I talking about? I was saying just something about 15 or 16. Sorry, 17.49. Let me type that in. 17.49. Will that be retested? Hey, 17.49. It could. There could still be some hazardous news out there, but I think we are trying to make some kind of a bottom. You need to see it at 20.30 above the pink 9-period moving average or 20.23, trying to get to 21.46, the 14-period moving average. And you need to see that, I would say, pretty soon. It's not too much time for messing around here. Your question about about the E-mini, yeah, that the E-mini. No, that's the NQ. E-mini right now is trading at. Yeah, the E-mini is trading at 2407, up 187. This is leg E in the 10-minute chart. Let me just show you that. What does it mean? I don't really want to go through that right this very moment because I've got questions that I want you to answer. I'll do that in a short while. I'll show the ChapmanWave methodology. And yes, I could do that. So this is now new ABC EFG. I'll just do this real quickly. This is an E, and that was an F, and everything pulled back, but it held beautifully above the 14 and the 9-period moving averages. So this is F/B, and I'm going to call this G/C just for now. And I could go into greater detail. I don't want to. I've got questions I need to answer. So I had a question. Let's see. There it go. Hi, good morning. I am a new subscriber. I wanted to check, as a subscriber of my opening call, wanted to check with you if Roku is on a ChapmanWave. Yeah, I've got it right here. Let me show you Roku. This is Roku Inc. Streaming devices made a peak C in the week, in the monthly chart. Looks like a C minus because it came down so sharply. It hit 176.55. Peak F in the daily, in the weekly chart on the week of the 23rd of September, happens to have fallen a little bit, went down to the 59s, 176 to 59. Oh, I would call that definitely almost a two-thirds decline. Now it's had a huge move up to, this is good. So this is part of the whole streaming service. The question, oh, you didn't tell me whether you're long or short. Oh, also one, yeah, you haven't told me. So I like this. I think it fits in this whole area of streaming. And I'm just going to say, I don't know what position you're in, but if you're looking to go long, it's a little late to say you've got a really good risk reward. But what I would say is you could start a position here at 100, but it has to be a small position saying, I want to go long. I suspect that the target of 104 to 111 is possible, maybe even 114, the 200-period moving average in the daily. I was looking at the weekly moving averages. So if that's the case, start a little bit here. I would have the patience to say if it filled the gap, today's low was 92.10. If it can get into the 91s, anytime in the 91s, I would add another small position. But you're taking a little bit of a risk in the sense that you're saying, I think the market's made a serious low and that any pullback will be minor. That's kind of my thinking now. But we want to have a stop. And a stop says that if you're prepared to have a 10% risk on a small position entered right now, I don't think I would want to make that risk greater. I'd say I'd rather miss the chance of a move on the upside than get stuck with a 15% loss in a stock that has the potential to make you a lot of money if you're able to keep your losses really small. I'm going to do this. I'm making it different. I'm going to give you a starting point right here at 101.28, and I would not add to it. I'd rather have a stop just in the very short term. About 92 was the low today. I'm not even giving you that. I'm saying on the day, 95, and if tomorrow it holds really well, we can talk about it again. Start a position, but you've got to have a stop of about 5% on this position. And I'll be right back, and then some other questions I'll answer in a few minutes. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technicians Hour, guys, now better, it's up at 17:38. Now, during the break, I'll complete my notations of the short-term trades. I'll be right back.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman Wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, everyone. So, picking up since we spoke a moment ago, 101.35. Someone says CRM, this is Salesforce.com, is moving up a little. And so it went from back in the, 115, was that a round number low? 115.29 yes, on the 18th, trading at 152. So way off its all-time high of 100 and, wasn't it 90-something? Yeah, 195.72. And that is definitely an F and not a B. So that's, let's change that F. Wow. What deep corrections there have been. Okay, so 152 on CRM. So just get back to the questions that I had here. Yeah, so Roku, as I said, this is the beginning of a move. I don't know if it's the move or a move, but it's a nice move, and do it one at a time. Next question I had was, and also he asked, what does a half position signify in the newsletter? When I say a half position, it usually means that if you're committed to that, you personally are committed to that stock in your overall portfolio, and you like what I've recommended, you can get a much bigger position, not a full position, but a really good position. But it's part of your portfolio, and sometimes people have a formula. I don't really have a formula because it has to be. For instance, I would not, on a very low price stock, get a full position by saying I'm going my full portfolio. I could get a full position, but it'll be a very large number of a small portion of my portfolio. So that's how I hope that explains it. So it's really a personal thing. It's just saying I have much more conviction if you're going to get in. You can get in because I think there could be a bigger move. If it really works, it's going to be a big one. Then we'll be able to take something off on the way or even add to it. The next question, I'll send you an email to answer that because a little more detail. Let me just have a look at some other questions that came in. Where was it? Oh, yes. I did get a trend reading, a very low reading of about 0.28 this morning. The Richard Arms short-term trading index, the Arms index. That should give you a weak Dow opening tomorrow. Now, does it, usually negative, does it mean that we have another, just let me go through this now while I can. What we're seeing at this particular point is the kind of takeoff that happens very rarely. We saw it in December of 2018, saw it, I think it was in June the 3rd. We actually got that one exactly at the low. And the December one of 18, we had bought call positions in the Dow, so we were prepared to see it go down lower. But once it started picking up, those call positions really expanded beautifully. So we've done the same thing now, just because I didn't want to miss an entry point, and I wanted to be sure we were in the Dow, the diamonds. So what we're looking at now is that there's a gap up. Let me just go through to the December one. There it is. Oops, December. Which December? Oh, this is the June 3rd. So you have the June 3rd. We have the doji candle, beautiful June candle, 24,701, June the 3rd. And then we gapped up, had a beautiful big candle, gapped up again, had a smaller candle, and just kept going green all the way from 24,701 to about 20, wasn't about, it was exactly 26,248. So that's almost 2,000 points. We've done that in a day. If you go back to the December one, let me just see if I can scroll back in. Let me just open this out, and we'll go back. Yeah, the December one, that was a different. That was with the low that was made was a huge green candle. That's different to yesterday because today we're looking closer to the June one. And then we had a pullback and then another big green candle. And then we actually ran from the 21,712 low of the 26th of December to a peak A 3 days later of 23,381. So that's not yet 2,000 points in a couple of days. As I say, we've almost done it in one day. We haven't closed yet. I'm just saying already we're up 1,700. We're up 1,700, but we're not up 1,700 from the close yesterday. We're up way more. So what is that? No, that doesn't make sense. We are from the close yesterday. So in this particular context, what are we looking for as follow through? What's the traditional pattern? The pattern is a lot of people have missed the low. Intraday now, they're starting to grab prices. That's why prices keep going higher and higher. Not everything's working, but some things are working really well. The next thing is there should be, if we close near the high of the day, and that's going to be almost like a Zumba candle. Now, we did make a little wick at the bottom. Usually they have no wick at the bottom, no wick at the top, but it's got that characteristic. And that says you could have a tiny little pullback with a doji candle if there's any uncertainty at all tomorrow. But if there is just gung-ho bullishness, you should get a gap up, and 20,731 is the pink. 9-period exponential moving average, the area of 20,670 is your Fib 138 thing. So a question I had was, how come we're starting to see on your charts more Fibonacci? Well, you know, I've said for years, I use Fibonacci, but when I start to see it being a little messy and I can't read my charts, I have to get rid of something. So I get rid of that, because normally, look, here we've got a resistance point. It turns out to be exactly the pink 20,734 9-period exponential moving average resistance. Then the next one, I don't have anything because it's 21,761. So that would be important. And the reason why I've kept it here is because it's just so clean to the downside. There have been hardly any peaks. Peak A minus, 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 minus. Hardly any follow-through upside action at all. Just lower lows and lower highs. Not even the ChapmanWave lowercase h pattern, the dreaded h, because it was just one bar up and then bam, down to new lows. So I've got space. That's all. I'll probably take them off sometime soon. Although I'm going to admit, I've been using them in the futures, and I've found that just for the techniques that I use, they have been very useful. Not only that, when you're going to higher highs that you've never been to before or haven't been to for a very long time, or lower lows that you haven't been to for a long time, this is a nice way to get extension levels, because you have no, you can have trend lines, rising trend lines or declining trend lines, but you have much else. And you don't even have moving averages because you're way below. So yes. So now we've just made the leg D in the E-mini. There's another one, yet another one, leg D. And it's a leg E in the 10-minute chart. That was the 2-minute chart. And that's suggesting that I have some techniques here that are suggesting we're getting a little bit close to some kind of a noontime, lunchtime breather. Of course, somewhere else is not lunchtime. I'm just calling it lunchtime for convenience. So there could be a breather where support levels between 23, we're at 24, 23. So 23.99 to 23.90 are really important. 10-minute intermediate term support levels, very short term, a close under 29.14 would say, you're going to have a bit more, a deeper correction. But so far, we haven't even got the turn yet. I'll be right back. I want to talk about the dollar, currencies, and gold and silver and copper. I'll be right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a 4-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal 4-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the 4-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The gold report took profits in 4 of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with 2 positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The gold report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the gold report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities.
To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the fund is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
A couple of quick things here. The USD Canadian, this is the US dollar and Canadian dollar, it's at 1.450. It's just made a double top over the last 4 days. Peak D in the weekly chart back in 2000, I think January of 2000, let me check. Yeah, January of 2000, 1.46888. And today, 4 days ago, it hit 1.46686. So look at that, almost a double top. Peak D, a leg E in the monthly chart. Peak D, if there's no new high, well, we'll just call it leg D for now. In the weekly chart, still very good technicals, and very good technicals in the daily, having a high-level consolidation. It should hold 1.41 on any big pullback, and if it breaks to a new recovery high, then 1.472 is probably the area that it'll go to. Another question I had was USD, AUD, Australian dollar. Oops, AUD, USD. I still have a couple of those left. Oh, no, I gave them to my grandkids. Trading at 0.5925. A nice little bounce stop dead at the pink 9-period moving average. We saw that in the euro. The euro went straight to the pink, and now it's even down a little more, 1.078. I still like the dollar. I don't know. Dollar and gold going. This is, we have not seen times like this ever. At least in my market lifetime that I've been fully aware of. I'm sure it's happened, but I just haven't seen it. Now, the other thing that we're looking at here that is really important, I want you to just show you the crude oil. The crude oil is now up 18 cents at 23.53. It had a big spike. It's making this little consolidation down here at the bottom. I don't see anything yet to say that the world economies are going to improve and that it should help crude oil. I'd like actually to see it up in the 26.80 to 30 area, 27 to 30 area, just because of world economy. I'd like to see it moving, but it isn't yet. And high-grade copper's had a nice bounce, but it's still way at the lower end. So world economies are still, this is going to be serious. So we're talking about a market, a climax of sorts of selling that's unfolding. It's not one of those V-shaped patterns, I don't think yet. Will it be a V-shaped pattern? I don't want to go through that again. Maybe a little later in the week, I'll go back and show you those monthly charts of 1929, how we've matched. But now we're matching the recovery part of it, the one that had, well, it's not exactly in the time frame, but it did have after that was usually, it was 3 months that it declined. In this particular instance, this is only our second month of the decline. So if we start off here, there could be one little messing around period in April. Doesn't have to go to the low of 18,917, or could go just lower, and then we start a big rally. And whatever rally it is, a rally should be at least, we've already gone to 20,391. Not good enough. I don't know if we'll get to the 23,900. Let's call it 24,200 period exponential moving average weekly chart, but there should be at least, there are going to be two fighting patterns. One is going to be the arch formation, like this, and the other is the V-shape formation. And that all is dependent over the next week that we don't break under 17,900. You go under that is so serious, that's a different kettle of fish altogether. So we want to see something like a V-shape formation. Two patterns fighting with one another. Both say you have to go up more before you either turn around and roll over. It's in the ChapmanWave methodology. I'll just show it to you really quickly here. What's the time? Yep, I've got time. See if I can find it. There it is. So ChapmanWave methodology, you try to identify the lowest low bar of consequence. And then if you do get that, it starts a buy signal. It goes to a buy mode when certain conditions are met. And the buy mode implies that you're not going to just go to four higher peaks, peak A, B, C, and D, but you could even go E, F, and G, but it's D that's the objective because it goes from a buy signal upgraded to a buy mode, certainly when it gets to leg C. And that says you should at least get to a D. That's the core of the technique. The patterns are straight line, down and up, arch formation, cup formation. The H pattern is a sharp down move with the cup formation, that arch formation that fails, takes out the left side low, you can go much lower. And the cup formation here, the inverted Y, says if you take out the left side high, you could go quite a bit higher. We saw that momentarily right here when we were looking at the, here we go, look, there it is. So you went to your D, there's your cup formation, you go to a D, and now I'm going to put a down arrow, because everything, the MACD's turned down, stochastic's under 80%, you've gone underneath the 14-period moving average, there should be a bit of a hiatus, spoke about this earlier, this is part of the ChapmanWave techniques. If you want to learn these techniques, my opening call, my daily newsletter, I go through these every day, I discuss them as great a detail as I can. I'm trying my best to cut back on all of that just to give you more picks with greater detail for the picks themselves. Let's see what happens. This is a leg E in the weekly chart so far. The 10-minute chart. So far, there's nothing here other than that shorter term 2-minute chart has turned down sharply. We'll see if this is a peak E, and that's what I was saying before. Remember I said 24, we were at 24, 26, I said, under 24, I think it was 15. It's a little bit of a problem. We're at 24.11 right now, and then you go to 24.02 is a 9-period exponential moving average, a 9-period moving average support level. MACD is still good in 10-minute, and stochastic's very strong in 94. Let me see. There we go. All right. So a couple of things that I want you to look at. I said crude oil. I did that. And now let's just run some of these stocks. AMZ. AMZ is up 26. It's actually struggling to get to the high of just 2 days ago. It tried there. It did 1955 round number. Actually pulling back a little bit. I think what we're seeing now is that Amazon was holding very well over the last week and a half, because it's really in a great area. But now maybe people will start to say, well, how are they going to deliver all these things? What if people can't go, et cetera? In the meantime, they have been the leader to hold support very nicely, all-time high at 2180 back in February, plunges down to 1626. So at 1930, it's kind of a little less than halfway. That's good. Question the Den Docu. Docu is one that we've had before. We actually tried to get, let me see, did we get close today? No, we just missed getting in. I like it, but I do think it's just in an area where it could chop around a little bit. It's up 2.62 and 86.12. It's only a peak B, a leg B, I should say, in the monthly chart. Still got the rest of the month to go. If it goes above 92.55 this month, that extends leg B. If it does it next month, it starts leg C. It hit the monthly 200-period moving average support. 14-period moving average support. That's about 67. This is a very nice 20-point move, a 30% move in such a short period of time. Yeah, I do like it. DocuSign Inc., electronic signing at 86.20, up 270. It's just getting a little, it's had so much of a big move that other stocks are getting an opportunity now. I wonder what Walmart's doing. Walmart, WMT, down today at 113, down 121. It had that big spike the other day because it actually was doing very successfully. It went to a leg E in the monthly, a weekly, and a leg E in the monthly. I think Walmart, it could hold well, but it might not be the leader at this particular time. We're going to have one segment to go. Got some questions that have come in. I'll try to get to them. Let me just see. Yeah, the airlines. This time we do want to look at the airlines. I'll be back. We'll look at Boeing. We'll look at the actual airlines themselves. I'll be right back. UAL. Let's see who that is.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
I had a bunch of questions. This came in from the den. Let me just go backwards here. So J&J wants to know about FSLY. That is Fastly. This is strange now. Ever since I saw the name for the first time, I thought, what a crazy name. It feels like it should be so good, but it doesn't sound right, Fastly. I'm going Fastly. Anyway, so 18.75 of 77. I like it. I think it's going to try to get to the 21.53, 200 period moving average. It's had a lot of trouble. It's an IPO. This is the low that it's made since its IPO. I think it's a bounce. I think it's going to take time. I think it's going to get to the 21.50s. It could even get to 22.85-ish. But then I think it could hang around for a little while. It needs time before it has a big spike to the upside. It is looking better, and I think it is off a low. I don't know if it's a V low, but it's looking okay right now. I don't like it red in the candle when it's up 82 cents on a day like this. I think it's going to struggle a little bit. 1780 is the short-term support that it must hold. Next one I had a question was, I should know them now. Oh, Square. Square has been a great stock. We had it once. And it went to, so this is a stock, 87.25 was the all-time high. No, 101 was the all-time high back in October of 2018. and then it's slumped sharply, like an A to B equals C to D. It's gone to a lower low in the 31, 32 area. It's a good candle today. My only concern was Square Point of Sale Inc. Trading at 48.62, up 8.61, up 21%, is that it's in the area that you need vendors, outdoor vendors, and everything's close. So I got a feeling that it could bounce, but it's going to sort of bounce around. 51 is the 200-period exponential moving average. I think it might get around there and then just go sideways. It definitely needs time. I needed another one. Yeah, there was another. Oh, T-Doc. This is the one that keeps getting talked about. This is Teladoc. We spoke about this way back. I can't remember. I think we even had it for a brief period. This is a brand new leg. Hey, this is fantastic. Teladoc Health, they're in the right area. But what do you do when it's at an all-time high? It was just the other day in the 105 area. Now it's 171. I think what you do is if you want it, you start a position, you close your eyes, you just buy it now. You put some kind of a stop that you're capable of holding. And you just hold your nose and say, hey, it just should keep going up because it's in the right area. But this is not the best risk reward. This is where it's really speculative. And there you are. So you're going to be going over to Steve Rhodes, then Dave White, Tom O'Brien. I'll be back with Tom a little later today. Have a wonderful day. And I hope to check out my opening call.